receive seed from SSK and our own silos, which we store into this little silo. We then draw the seed into the plant via conveyors into the first conditioner. From the conditioner, it runs through a magnet, vibratory feeder, and into a flaking roller. The flaking roller's task is to flake open the seed so that inside of the seed is expelled, so we can heat the seed up to get rid of the oil. Then we transfer it to the further three conditioners, after which it then runs into the press. The press is a screw press. This stage we press out most of the oil, and there's still about 16% of oil left in the product, which is called oil cake, which is then fed to the extraction plant. The oil that came out of the press is filtered through a screening stand firstly, and then through a press filter, and then pumped into the storage tanks of the crude oil. In the pressing plant, we mentioned the oil cake, which is storage of oil, which is fed via this conveyor into the extractor. The purpose of the extractor is to extract the oil with a chemical called hexane. Hexane is pumped on top of the oil cake. It extracts the oil out of the cake, and which is then run into two settling tanks. The oil cake is then fed via a conveyor into a DT, desolventizer toaster, where we inject a live steam to get rid of the hexane, which goes out in a vapor form at 74.5 degrees. Then we dry the product, we cool it down, and we send it down to the oil cake store, where we pack it for animal feed. The rest of the process goes further to the distillation unit. Distillation takes place. We take the extracted oil and hexane mixture, which is called micellar. We pump it into distillation columns, where we slowly heat it up under high vacuum. The hexane is then pulled off with a vacuum into a condenser, which is cooled down and then fed back into the plant. It just follows the condensers right up, where we get to the last stage, where we add a live steam also under a vacuum to strip the last bit of hexane. The oil is then fed into a storage tank, where we do water degumming, and after the degumming, it is pumped through into the crude oil storage tanks, which is then ready for refining. In this plant, this is what we call refining. The first stage is to neutralize the oil in two neutralizers. After neutralization, the next process is bleaching. The last step in the whole refining process is called deodorizing. Deodorizing's purpose is to get rid of the smells and the taste in the oil. Right, the laboratory is running 24 hours, 7 days a week, same as the plant. The purpose of the lab is firstly to test all seed that we receive during the year for oil content, protein and moisture. Secondly, it is there to test crude oil for FFA, peroxide and color, as well as soap content. Thirdly, we test the final or the bleach oil for color and FFA. And then lastly, we test the final oil for color, FFA and peroxide. The oil is pumped from the final storage tank in the plant into these three tanks. From there, we pull it into this loading hopper, and from there it flows volumetrically into the bottles. It comes around the machine, caps is put onto the bottle, and then it comes around where it is sealed, goes around to the back part of the machine, where it is then labeled and packed into the bottle or into the boxes. And that's it.